Hi, everybody. Welcome to today's Heart to Home devotion. And today we're going to talk about the reason for the season. We come to the end of 2023 Christmas season. And I went to a program at my granddaughter's church. And they did a little program and a play. And then the pastor got up and he said he was going to talk about the reason for the season. And he said, you know, we see those bumper stickers and we see it on people's lawns and their garages, the reason for the season. And he goes, but it's not what you think. And here's what he said. He said, the reason for the season is not the birth of Christ. It's sin. Sin is the reason for the season. Because without sin, Christ wouldn't have had to come to earth as a baby and live as a human and be crucified and take on our sin. But because we are sinners, and sin entered the world, that's the reason for this season. He had to come to earth, be a baby, live as a man, and go through what we go through, the challenges, the temptations, all the things, you know. So sin appears 369 verses. So God puts a lot of weight on sin, and it's pretty much what the whole book's about. We're not righteous, and God can't look upon sin, so he had to come down and humble himself because he's the perfect sacrifice. In Romans 5:12, it says, therefore, just as through one man sin entered the world, and death through sin, and thus death spread to all men, because all have sinned. And we jump down to Romans 5:17 through 19. It says, for if by the one man's offense death reigned through the one, much more those who receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness will reign in life through the one, Jesus Christ. Even so, through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification of life. For as by one man's disobedience, many were made sinners, so also by one man's obedience, many were made righteous. And that's what Christ has done for us. Even though we've rejected him in our lives and come to realize our need for him. And he offered us a free gift. We just have to accept it. And let's go to 2 Corinthians 5, 21. For he made him who knew no sin to become sin for us, that we might become the righteous of God in him. In 1 John 3:5, and you know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him there is no sin. Romans 6:23 tells us, and this is why he had to do all this, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. In the Old Testament, sin always represents death. The only way to deal with sin is by death. And in the Old Testament, it was sacrifices. But they were never the perfect sacrifice. They were just a covering, a kofar. And then they would have to do it again and again and again and again to cover our sins until Christ came and became the perfect sacrifice. And through him, we've all been saved from our sins if we just accept his free gift of salvation. In our last verse today is Psalms 51:2, and this is what we say once we realize our need for Christ and his sacrifice on our behalf. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. And all we can say to that is thank you, Lord. And hope you have a good day, and we'll see you next time.